let's say this is the force and the name of the force is P. It's a force P. There is another force, its name is Q. And if I'm having a third force, if this force is R, the question is the resultant and direction of the resultant. Okay. So in that case, I will resolve the forces, the components of the forces along x-axis and y-axis. Okay, beta. So can you help me? How can I resolve the forces? Do you think some information is missing here?
Yeah, the angle is missing.
Yes, very good. So beta, let's say this angle is 30 degree and here this angle is 60 degree, because without angle we can't do anything. And one more thing is missing, that is it's we need to draw the arrows. Okay, because these are forces, so that's why we need to draw the arrows, that these arrows will represent the direction. Okay, so 30 degree, 60 degree, these are the forces. If I resolve the first force P into its components, then I must have this option that I will draw a horizontal line and then I will draw a vertical line, and then I will say that these two components are, it must be P cos 30, that is P sine 30, is it?
Yes.
Okay, beta. I'm just taking a general example. I'm not discussing some particular question, so that's why. So P cos 30 degree, and here it is P sine 30. So this is my complete sum of forces along x-axis. Got it?